Lovely, happy National Drawing Day. My name is Sian Costello. I'm a portrait artist from Boyle in County Roscommon, and I've been asked by Roscommon Arts Centre to talk to you about the This Is Me exhibition happening on June 13th in the Arts Centre itself. So what we want you to do is to make your own self-portraits at home. I'm going to do a short video now on how to do so. And send it in to us. Do it on an A4 sheet of paper. Write your name beside it and your age. And they'll be sent off, printed out within the Arts Centre and plastered onto the lovely big windows we have in there. So once you walk past it in town, or your mother, your grandmother, your grandfather, everybody will be able to see your lovely artwork. It'll be done on a rotating basis. So if you don't see it one week, you'll see it the next, hopefully. So I suppose now I better get going on showing you how to do a portrait. Alright, I've got my tunes ready to go, and this was my first attempt at a self-portrait done in chalk. So we've got chalk, we've got these pencils here. You can use anything that you find about the house. I would advise using dry materials, and don't be getting any paint smeared up on your family scanners now, I would say. So these are just chalk pastels. They're basically fancy chalks that you'll find around the house. Oil pastels are the same, they're just fancy crayons really. I'm using chalk now, and I'll tell you why. It's because it's lovely to smudge. So it's a really nice way to go about making a portrait, by smudging all of these skin tones. So I'm going to go at it now and show you how I made this portrait, or as best as I can replicate. So I like to look at the sitter and kind of squint my eyes and say to myself, right, I'm an awful sort of pinky yellow colour. So I'll start off with the pink, and I'll do a kind of a head, a shape. Doing that on A4 paper now, so don't be shy, go quite big. That's a head. I'll colour it in. Hot pink. Not really sure I get around. It's a nice wide head. I'm going to go down into the neck as well. Does not have to be perfect at all. You're going to be fixing it as you go along. And now for my yellow tinge. So I'm going to go in the opposite direction now. So looking at this now, doesn't look as much like a head as you'd like it to be, I would say. So we've got to put in some features. So if you think of the head, every head is the same really, proportion wise. If you take your head, you're going to have halfway down that, from the top of your hair to the end of your chin, is where your eyes lie. There's a line there and your eyes go through them, so we'll mark that off. Just, I might do it in pencil actually, green to be sure. Halfway between that again, between your nose and your chin, you'll find where your nostrils lie. That's a bit lower really. Now we're going by the first chin, not the second chin, I would say. Now, you can have that again and you'll find where the bottom of the lips go. So you'll have the line of the mouth somewhere around there, the nostrils somewhere here, and the eyeballs around here somewhere. I'm not going to put those in pencil yet because we want to keep it really loose. So I'm going to squint my eyes again and look at my reflection and say, right, it's a fine red patch here where the other mouth goes. There's another one here. With each nostril, and my nose, I got caught in the sun lately, so I'm quite rosy. And then in the tear ducts as well, basically, if you look at the head, any place that oozes, any sort of secretion, goes red. That's not a nice way to think about it, but it's dead on. You've got your tear ducts, your nostrils, your mouth, even your wee ears. Now, a thing to remember for the ears, they follow a similar pattern of proportion. the top of your ear matches where your eyebrow will go, so you mark that there. And the bottom of it matches your nostrils again. Now this is if you're looking dead on, if you're tilting your head up or down or doing any sort of mad angles, which you are welcome to do. That's going to of course change. But I'm just going to do a nice dead straight on head. I'm going to colour in my hair as well because I'm looking a bit bald looking. Now an important thing to remember is that although I have brown hair, what I'm looking at doesn't look brown to me. It looks nearly blacky blue. And that's a large part to do with what light you're doing it in. I'm doing this in my bedroom at night. You might have a beautiful daylight to be at and see everything perfectly clearly. It's going to be very rough. So I'm going to add some blue because that's what I see. I'm actually going to make this a lot bigger, I think. Expand the head. Don't be worrying at all about where your marks are. They're yours. You can do what you like with them. So if you want to go bigger, smaller, change things, go for it. Now, all I've done with this fella is I've made it bigger, first of all. I've enlarged it, but all the proportions stay the same. So you've got half and half for the line of the eyes, got half of that for the end of the nose, and half of that again, so we're in eighths now, to the bottom of the lip. So you can see I've done them out in quite red, quite visceral pinks. And then my secret weapon is this white chalk. So as you can see here now, I've gone ahead and I've blended everything together. And when you're blending, you see all these like kind of dusty marks coming away. That's very specific to working with chalk pastel, and you'd be very tempted to blow it away. But during this stage, they're very helpful. Because all those are just loose pigment, and you can mush them into the paper as much as you wish. So you end up with this very, very blended skin tone. It's just a face of flesh, quite terrifying after a while. And when you're making your marks, think about how the skin sits on the face. I know it sounds horrible, but if you think about how the skin is nearly stretched over your nose and comes down into your cheeks and around to the chin, just like the contours of your face. Give yourself a feel. So it comes down like so. And you can even keep adding some of those base colours that you had as well. So I have my ochre and my pink. I'm going to add a bit more ochre to around where the mouth is. So I find with most people, when you draw them or paint them, most people have a kind of a greeny grey tinge around the mouth. I'm going to add that. Don't be afraid of going over the pink, you'll still see it. And you can add it back in. That is the beauty of these fellas. Chalk pastels, I find, are the closest I can get to drawing without paint. I'm used to working with oil paints and I have big brushes. I get marks down very quickly. It's a lot slower process with drawing. Around the forehead as well. It's a lot sort of more yellowy. Thinking again of the skin going straight, being pulled up towards your hairline. Where's my cheeks? I'm a very red person. I get very flushed very quickly. They come down the whole way down my cheek. And I've also caught the sun, so that's not helping. Fine red nose. And I'm going to come down again around this cheek. I'm going to reinforce that pink there where the mouth is. And in again, towards the main areas where your tear ducts, your nostrils, and the lobes of your ears. Well, I think it's time we made this look a bit more lifelike. So I'm going to take my pencil. This is a charcoal pencil. You can use any pencil that you have. Or even, I have some black chalk here that would work as well. I'm going to use this because it's quite precision. So I'm going to just sketch in some of the really dark elements. So again, if you squint at yourself, you're going to see different areas that are a lot darker than others. They really jump out at you when you squint your eyes. Makes everything clearer. The eyes, obviously, the eyelashes. A lot of people, when they're drawing eyes, they'll either, you start off doing a circle with a dot in it. Then you learn that eyes are nearly sort of almond shaped. I never find any of that helpful. I think it's best to just look at what you're looking at. Because everyone has a different shaped eye. You've hooded lids, you have people with almond eyes, you have people with all sorts. So always keep looking at what you're drawing, which is yourself. Now for the corners of the mouth, I'm just going to mark them here. If you hold up a pencil to your face, you're going to see that the corners of your mouth match this part of your eye. Around mid iris, I have quite a tight mouth, so it's going to fall a bit closer together. Same this side. And the eyebrows, we'll just do a small thing. You can kind of, once you have the eyes in place, I feel like you can learn, figure out a lot of what's happening. Of course, everyone has differently shaped eyebrows, and this whole business is now to shape your eyebrows in different ways and fashions. Mine are called bushy. Right. Now, I'm just going to, again, take my charcoals, and this time I can add new colours. So I've got brown, I've got a sort of greeny colour, and I've got the sort of browny, reddy, rusty colour. This side of my face, I feel, has gotten a bit rustier. I don't know if that's the sun or the lighting that we have. So just keep looking. Figure out what suits. I'm going to take the blue for my eyes because that's the most exciting bit, is putting in the eyes. Now, nobody's eyes are this blue. Well, maybe there are some. Very lucky people. It's a beautiful colour. But of course, once you lay it down on this paper, which is sodden with all different colours of chalk, it's going to change colour. Now, even at that, it's different from how it looks on the chalk, but it's still not like my quite dark, nearly grey bluey eyes. I'm going to add a bit of black there. And white. Again, if you look at anyone's eyes, the whites of their eyes are never perfectly white. Mine are nearly sort of a blue in this colour. In this light, sorry. But as you put it down, as I said earlier, you'll find that the white never really sits as white. In there. I'll go back with some red around that. So I'll just continue at this now, sort of adding in more colours, being a bit more careful about how I place these colours, not as flahoolic as I was beforehand. And we'll add some details as we go along. Now, for the eyebrows, this really is a lesson in not taking what you see for granted. Blow a bit of that away so I can see properly. So I'm looking at my eyebrows and you think brown hair, but I'm actually going to go at them here with a bit of blue. And just very lightly pop that in. Now you'd be tempted to go and do the same, but hold your horses. We'll just finish this one first. Because I'm not in a direct and constant light, you're going to have some differences in tone. So I added a bit of brown, and I'm actually going to go at it with a small bit of, where is it, some ochre here now. And now with my pencil, I'll pick out the hairs and really notice what direction they're going in. I think this always really brings it to life. Otherwise you've got a very sort of Mona Lisa look going on. Of course you can always draw over that again if you want to add a bit more ochre, which I might do. A bit more pink around here. Now I say hold your horses for the eyebrows, because this one I'm going to use a bit of green eyebrows, she says. And it's purely just drawing what you see. So I see these kind of green shadows coming out. And even a bit of pink there blends up into the forehead. Now I'm a devil for a lazy forehead. It's just a big, smooth stretch of skin. Don't really know what to do with it a lot of the time. I'm going to make it a bit pinker because, as I say, I have caught the sun. And there. And go at this eyebrow again. It's actually easier if you have big bushy eyebrows like I do to draw them in. I find people who have fabulously manicured eyebrows can come out looking rather strange. Now that I have this in my hand, I'm going to start attacking my hairline and see how it goes. Just following the lines. Once you have that kind of background in, it's easy enough to just suggest the hair with a few lines. Look at the direction in which it's going. Mimic it. Fix that bit. And now I'm just going to add in a rough guide of where my earrings are. Go for it when you're doing the earrings. Or whatever you're wearing. Jewellery, clothes. All those choices that you make in the morning as to how you're going to look. Really important in a portrait. So that's how you present yourself to the world. Rather than in a drawing or anything like that. Now guys, I think I am ready, soon enough anyways, to call a halt to this drawing. I've just been putting in a few more details. Notice my hair has become a bit loose. I'm putting that in. I'm just putting in a bit of shading for that and for the earrings, for the collar as well. I'd be really interested to see what you do with your clothes. I think it'd be really cool if you had like a really nice patterned shirt. You could do all sorts with that. We're really looking for just a head and shoulders. And when you're done, if you write your name beside it, I'm going to say it'll be easy for us and your granny and granddad and everyone to see how you guys are getting on in quarantine. And I think it's a really lovely thing to do, both for yourself and for your family to see. And I challenge all of you to paint a smiling face. I am incapable of painting someone smiling or drawing them at all. But I would love to see some really happy smiley faces, guys. So, yeah. Thanks for joining me. And best of luck out there. And send on your submissions to Roscommon Arts Centre. We look forward to seeing what you make.